Greetings, fellow chemists. Welcome to Awesome Chem. Today, we will be synthesizing ammonium acetate for an upcoming project. We are short of chemicals on hand and have decided to make the ammonium acetate with a rather unorthodox method. We will be reacting potassium hydroxide with aqueous ammonia or ammonium hydroxide to create ammonia gas. The gas will be bubbled through glacial acetic acid, forming the acetate of ammonia. As you will soon see, our lack of experience with ammonia has led to a spectacular failure in the lab. Let's get started. We used the last bit of glacial acetic acid that we had left on hand, approximately 51 ml. The measurements we are using are quite arbitrary, which does not matter because we just need lots of ammonia gas. We measured out about 45 ml of 29% ammonium hydroxide. Again, these are not accurate measurements. Now it is time to set up the apparatus. Once the ammonium hydroxide is added, we must work quickly to assemble the tube and to get proper bubbling. However, we were too hasty and one of our lab technicians accidentally poured in all of the ammonium hydroxide at once. Fortunately, we were wearing sufficient protective gear such as smocks, goggles, respirators, and gloves which minimized any potential harm. We were simply too impatient, and we should have waited for more supplies to come in to do this the proper way. Okay, we are back with a new apparatus and some new chemicals. Let's give this another go. We purchased some calcium oxide and some more glacial acetic acid. The calcium oxide should be able to dry the ammonia gas as it passes through the tubes. Other drying agents like calcium chloride would not work as most drying agents react with ammonia gas. Let's add in our potassium hydroxide to the reaction flask. And now the calcium oxide to the drying tube. This should absorb any water that makes it out of the flask. We want our product to be as anhydrous as possible. We decided to use an addition funnel to add the aqueous ammonia. This will allow us to easily control the rate of the reaction without letting gas escape. And finally the glacial acetic acid. We wanted to add this last to minimize the amount of moisture in the air it is exposed to. And now let's get this reaction going. We want the rate of addition to be very slow to minimize the amount of water that is vaporized. Thank you. The acetic acid heats up as the gas bubbles through, melting the ammonium acetate that started to form. We continued bubbling and then chilled the mixture for about 20 minutes to get the ammonium acetate to recrystallize. We removed the cover that we put on to prevent exposure to moisture in the air. It is time to filter. We loaded up our vacuum desiccator with sodium hydroxide and prepared to dry the ammonium acetate for a few days. Our yield was about 3 grams. Thank you for watching this episode of Boss and Chan. Be sure to tune in next time. We have many exciting new projects soon to be posted for your entertainment. Boss and Chan signing off.